75% off sale on Steam. Well, let's get this game. I'm gonna choose my name as L from Island Bay, because I'm from Island Bay. Well, just look at the detail and the amazing graphics in this game. Introduction.
Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time.
Awesome, how awesome is this? I get to sit in the driver's seat. How cool is that? And you get to interact with people in this game and interact with objects such as doors and chairs. Get to play as the passenger in this game, which is cool. Time to get some vitamin D at every stop. I'm one of those drivers, yep. Look at the graphics in this game, so detailed. And coming up to a triangle bridge. I love that sun and nature around us and vitamin D. Time for another stop at another station. And look, the passenger doors also open and close. Oh, here's another train. Another stop.
ICE-3M high-speed electric train.
And a high-speed train. This is quite so. Excuse me while I crash your party there. You know, it's quite party. So you get to interact with many objects in this game, which is good. So doors, you get to hear them close and open, which is cool. And you get to sit next to passengers as well and roam the cabins as well. So it's not just a cockpit view game with a million switches. Hey everyone, welcome to another video. I did get this game very early April, but I've been quite busy lately that I've finally had time to get this video out and prepped and uploaded to my YouTube channel. So my custom desktop PC has good graphics and good hardware. So I decided to get a Train Sim World 2 off Steam early April, because you save, instead of paying $50 for it, I've only paid $12.49 New Zealand currency. So it's cheaper than what Microsoft charges, even though with Microsoft, if you get it through them, you get be able to play it on your Xbox console and PC. I just went with the Steam version. So time to choose a gamer tag or gamer name for me. I chose Al from Island Bay because Al's my nickname, and I'm from Island Bay, which is a southern coastal suburb. And when you live in a suburb this beautiful, I'm just going to talk about my suburb for a few minutes here. It's great. I love it. It's the best suburb in Wellington, in my opinion. So we're boarding an electric, 100% electric double-decker bus, which is busy. This was during March 2020, I think, the day of the new town fair here, so it's quite a busy bus here. And the number one Island Bay bus service in Wellington is one of the busiest in Wellington.
Let's sit down again, I guess.
Amazing view from up top.
What is going on?
So this is a let's play of Train Sim World 2. It's the second version. Time to lead on the Island Bay peeps, residents, so we can go to Island Bay. Okay, and this is one of the Transurban Metlink 100% electric double-decker buses. It's real cool. And living in Island Bay, it's a blessing, because you get all this beautifulness and natureness. It's a beautiful suburb, peaceful, safe, and unique and friendly, which sets apart from other suburbs in Wellington. Good playgrounds, good parks, good beach. And we have these giant oak trees that line the west side of the parade, which is the main and widest road in Island Bay. And you get to walk on the beach, which is Island Bay Beach, and the water is so clean. So sometimes, yeah, I'm just really happy to be here in this 2020, I think, Island Bay Festival. We've got the Wellington Police Boat, which is the Queen Elizabeth IV. So this is real cool. And an up close from this year shot of the Queen Elizabeth IV Wellington Police Boat. Island Bay is a great suburb to live with, tucked away from most of the hustle and bustle of the city. Even has an aquarium. Only very few places in Wellington have aquariums. Island Bay is one of them. It's not the largest like Cully Towton's and Sydney Aquarium, but it's still an aquarium and it's really good since we're considered an outer suburb of Wellington City. Located on the southern fringe of the urban area. So this was from 2020, some gymnastics going here at the Island Bay Festival from February 2020. Amazing stuff. And this program from the festival in 2020, it was called Big Year. I didn't go to it in 2019 because I didn't know much about it, but I'm glad that I attended it in 2020. So talking about trains, some World 2, I'll get to the some gameplay very soon. I just want to share with you some scenes, visual stimuli of what it's like to live being an Island Bay resident. It's really great. So this is one of the streets, Avon Street, near where I live. And this is the famous parade march, which happens every February. It's in part of the Island Bay annual event in Wellington. Suburban event. Marching down the main road and which is called the parade. And this shot was from 2019.
Oh my god! Are you serious?
Big year, 26. So yeah, Island Bay is located about 7 kilometres south of the Wellington CBD. So it's tucked away from most of the hustle and bustle of city life, which is good. People are also friendlier here as well. Gotta get out that smartphone to record. She's a content creator, probably. Okay, so this is the Island Bay Festival March, continuing on the parade near the beach, Island Bay Beach. It's a great, amazing community here. Island Bay Festival on Reef Street, outside Shoreland Park, and we've got some live performances in Shoreland Park.
If you're looking at the stage, it's on your right, it's the children's area. The Teddy Bears picnic lasts about 30-35 minutes, and that's happening now as we speak.
And I love this group here, Shanty Society. Yeah, they're really good. They've got some amazing performance music. Yeah, so welcome back to Train Sim World 2. These are the settings that I play. I got a 4K TV which I play on. I use for Xbox and streaming videos as well. And I play on the higher settings. So let's play some. In this video, I'm going to share with you guys some driver gameplay. Let's play. So I'm going to about to leave you with the rest of this video, which is under 55 minutes long. Not much of a commentary here today, but I thought I might get this out and put this into my video. This game is really amazing. It's got really good graphics. I love it, and the good thing about it, I rate it a 10 out of 10 as a simulation game. It's not as complicated and complex as playing Flight Simulator or Microsoft Flight Simulator. It's much more easier because you don't have to deal with a million dials. The game developers really help make this game much more easier to play, even though it's much more better with a controller or a joystick, that kind of thing, because when you're driving and playing this on PC, you're always looking down at the throttle, and that can distract you from the rear ahead, which is why I always slow down when trying to drive these trains much sooner than I should. But I might invest into like the Xbox version or get a sort of like a controller, wireless controller that I can easily, without having to look down at the center console, which is good. So Trains Sim World 2, this is an amazing game. You should get it if you don't have it, and if you love this kind of thing. So I'm going to leave you with the rest of this video. Enjoy.
With power available, use the master switch to unlock the control desk and turn on the multifunction displays. The reverser determines the direction of travel. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and makes contact with the overhead catenary. Set the exterior lights for normal operation. Set the indirect brake to release. This brake is generally not required during normal operation, but can be used in cases of emergency. Finally, disengage the parking brake. Use the combined power brake handle to apply power and get going. Coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable and safe stop. Take a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. Proceed to the next stop at Aachen Rote Erde, unguided this time, and see how you get on. Good work. That concludes all of the basics of operating this train. Welcome to driver training. Here you will be taken through the operation of an ICE 3M high-speed electric train. During this brief introduction, we will go through the train preparation, critical driving controls, and passenger operations. When you are ready, climb aboard to get started.